فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
نعم. So الحافظ رحمه الله after speaking about if Hassan and Sahih are mentioned together, he goes into a topic called inshallah, which is زيادة الثقات. الزيادة زيادات الثقات. Okay, which is if a reliable person adds additional matter to a hadith, what is the ruling regarding it? This is what he wants to talk about. Now, the thiqa here, brothers, وَزِيَادَةُ رَاوِيهِمَا مَقْبُولَةٌ. The additional that is added to a hadith, whether it comes from a Hassan narrator or a Sahih narrator, is accepted. وَزِيَادَةُ رَاوِيهِمَا. Hima that is talking about the dual is who? Hassan and Sahih. So Ibn Hajar is saying, if a hadith comes as a Sahih or it comes as a Hassan, it is maqbula, meaning it is accepted. مَا لَمْ تَقَعْ, as long as it doesn't fall, مُنَافِيَةً لِمَنْ هُوَ أَوْثَقُ, as long as it doesn't oppose what? As long as it doesn't oppose another person who is more thiqah than he is. So he's thiqah, and I said, brothers, thiqah is a person who's adlun babid. A person who's adl, his reliability is there, and his babid, his memory is there. Okay? Are you all with me? Yeah. That hadith is called, that person is called a thiqah. That person is called a thiqah. So Ibn Hajar rahimahullah, he's trying to say that hadith is taken. He's trying to say that hadith is, it's taken. As long as he doesn't go against another person who's higher than him in what? The thiqah. As long as it isn't. The opposition, the ziyada, the adding of an additional rawi who's a thiqah, it happens in three ways. The ziyada that occurs of a narrator becoming alone on something who is thiqah. If he adds something to it, he's alone on it, right? It happens in three different ways. One is the one that Ibn Hajar refuted, which is that he's singular in, and that he narrated additionally, مُنَافِيًا لِمَنْ رَوَاهُ سَائِرُ الثِّقَاتِ. It goes against what the other reliable scholars of hadith have narrated. So there's an opposition here. فَهَذَا حُكْمُهُ الرَّدِ. That one is rejected. And that one takes the ruling of, that is called Shad, and we're going to come to it. That one is what? It's rejected. So أَيَّقَعَ مُخَالِفًا. It means that he falls by opposing مُنَافِيًا لِمَا رَوَاهُ سَائِرُ الثِّقَاتِ. He goes against what the other reliable narrators have narrated. فَهَذَا حُكْمُهُ الرَّدِ. This one's hadith is rejected. وهو الشاد, and it's called شاد, I'm going to come to it inshallah. The next one is called يرحمك الله. The second one is أَلَّا يَكُونَ فِيهِ مُنَافَات. There's no opposition. So the additional thing he added to it has, it doesn't go, or it doesn't oppose anyone else. أَلَّا يَكُونَ فِيهِ مُنَافَات. There is no opposition. He doesn't go against anyone. أَصْلًا لِمَا رَوَاهُ غَيْرُ. That other than him have narrated. It doesn't. Like the hadith, a lot of scholars of hadith have narrated, and you don't find in their narrations any what? Any form of... Example is the hadith that was narrated by Imam Muslim from the chain of narration of Ali ibn Mushirin. Imam Muslim narrated it. Muslim narrated on the chain of Ali ibn Mushirin, who narrated from Sulaiman ibn Mehran al-A'mash, and then al-A'mash narrated it from Abi Razin, who then narrated from Abi Salih, who then narrated from Abi Hurairah, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And there's an additional adding to the hadith, which is what? When the Prophet ﷺ spoke about, when the Prophet ﷺ spoke about, the dog. إِذَا وَلَغَ الْكَلْبُ فِي إِلَىٰ أَحَدِكُمْ. If a dog, it puts its tongue inside one of your vessels, وُلُوغُ الْكَلْبُ, the Prophet said, wash it seven times. أُولَاهُنَّ بِالتْرَابِ. First one should be what? Sand. Or dust. Or dirt. So here, That narration of Muslim, it adds to the hadith, فَلْيُرِقْهُ. We took it when we do it, عُمْدَةُ الْحَكَامِ. He should pour it. He should pour it. That additional that is added to the hadith, the other huffaz, the other scholars of hadith, from the students of Sulaiman ibn Mihran, A'mash, from the students of Sulaiman ibn Mihran, none of the students have narrated this hadith. Except who? Except who? Ali ibn Mushirin. Ali ibn Musir is the only one who narrated this actual wording, which is فَلْيُرِقْهُ. All the other students of Sulaiman ibn Mihran A'mash, they didn't add that word to it. They narrated it, إِذَا وَلَغَ الْكَلْبُ فِي إِنَاءِ أَحَدِكُمْ فَلْيَغْسِلْهُ سَبْعًا مِرَارًا. Yes. فَلْيُرِقْهُ, they didn't add it to it. But does فَلْيُرِقْهُ go against the hadith? The water is gone impure. So you can't even use it. So you have to pure, you have to what? Pour it. So that additional meaning, that additional wording that's added to the hadith, because Ali ibn Mushirin, he is a thiqa, reliable person. His ziyada here, la yadur, it doesn't harm. فَتُقْبَلُ تُلْكِ الزِيَادَ. So this ziyada we will take. The other one, which is the first one, which is the shad version, which we're going to come to inshaAllah ta'ala, is, for example, the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where it said in it, يوم عرفة, the day of عرفة, ويوم النحر, and the day of نحر, وأيام التشريع, and the days of تشريع, عيدنا, they are our عيد, أهل الإسلام, the people of Islam, وهي أيام, and it's the days of what? أكل وشرب, it's the days where you eat and you drink, you're not allowed to fast those days. If you bring all the narrations of the hadith together, this one, فإن الحديث من جميع طرقها, all of these chains of narration, when you bring it together, وإنما جاء بها موسى ابن علي ابن رباح, who narrated from his father, who narrated from عقبة ابن عامر, and the other chains of narration are narrated from Tirmidhi and Abu Dawud and غيرهما. So يوم عرفة is not in the chain. Does this go against the other hadith? Of course it does. It's an additional ruling added to an additional day, which doesn't share with the rest. So here we say is a munafat, it goes against it. Okay? It goes against it. So that's the second one. So that's the first one we mentioned, which is أَيَقَعَ مُخَالِفًا مُنَافِيًا لِمَا رَوَهُ سَائِرُ الثِّقَاتِ. The second one is what? أَلَّا يَكُونَ فِيهِ مُنَافَاتِ. There is no munafat, meaning there's no opposition. وَمُخَالَفَ أَصْلًا لِمَا رَوَهُ غَيْرُهُ لِمَا رَوَهُ غَيْرُهُ. There's no opposition. And I give the example for that. Khatib al-Baghdadi, he brought an ittifaq, agreement, according to the ulama of hadith, he said, that this type of hadith, which doesn't have no opposition, that it should be taken. Are you with me? That it should be taken. And there's a third type, which is مَا يَقَعُ بَيْنَ هَاتَيْنِ الْمَرْتَبَتَيْنِ. There's one that falls between the two. There's no opposition, and there's not an agreement. It's in between the two. مِثْلَ زِيَادَةُ لَفْضِي فِي الْحَدِيثِ. And this is like what? Adding an additional word to hadith. Other scholars of hadith have narrated that hadith, and they haven't mentioned that particular wording. For example, to become clear, is the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where he said, where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, جُعِلَتْ لَنَا الْأَرْضِ. The earth was made for us, مَسْجِدًا, a masjid. وَجُعِلَتْ, and it was made, تُرْبَتُهَا, its sand, its dust, was made, لَنَا طَهُورًا. It was made for us, what? Pure. So pondering this hadith, جُعِلَتْ لَنَا الْأَرْضُ, the earth was made a masjid everywhere. وَجُعِلَتْ تُرْبَتُهَا, its dust was also made what? لَنَا طُهُورًا. Good. This ziyada of the hadith, which is the word تُرْبَتُهَا, أَبُو مَالِكِ الْأَسْجَعِ, he is the one who added this additional to it. The other wording of the hadith is what? The other narrators, how do they narrate it? The other narrators, they narrated it, وَجُعِلَتْ لِيَ الْأَرْضُ مسجدا وطهورا. Okay, sorry. Abu Musa, Abu Malik al-Ajja'i, he ziyada is what? He narrated it with the word وَجُعِلَتْ لَنَا. It was made for us. Us. Are you guys with me?
Yeah.
But the other narrators, how did they narrate it? وَجُعِلَتْ لِي. It was made for me, the Prophet saying. Are you with me? Are you all with me?
Yeah.
So the ziyada here is li and lana. Are you guys with me? So here, it's a bit tricky. Because there is a difference between the li and la. There is an opposition here. Are you guys with me?
Yeah.
There is an opposition. If a person says, I did this, and later tells you, we did this, you're going to say it's the same.
No.
Good. So there is a khilaf amongst the two. But there isn't in the sense where if it was made for the Prophet, and there's no evidence to show that it's uniquely for him, then also the other people share it with him. Are you with me? So here, that's why it's got a leg inside this one, meaning there is a khilaf in terms of its wording. The wording is a khilaf. And also, there isn't in a sense where the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, even though he was the one it was made for, then everyone who comes later shares that with him. And that is not uniquely for him, alayhi salatu wasalam. So from that angle also, there's no munafat. So that's the third, three types. And all those three types I mentioned, Ibn Salah is the one who I took it from. Ibn Salah is the one that mentioned those three types. Then Ibn Hajar rahimahullah, he said, فَإِنْ خُولِفَ بِأَرْجَحَ فَالرَّاجِحُ الْمَحْفُوظُ وَمُقَابِلْهُ الشَّاذُ. فَإِنْ خُولِفَ, if they oppose each other. Now we took if they what? There's an additional, there's no khilaf, there's a ziyada, the sahih and the hasan, both of our, there's no khilaf. Now the Shaykh is saying, rahimahullah, what about if there is a khilaf? The one that opposes, فَإِنْ خُولِفَ, if there's a this khilaf between two hadiths, okay? Between what? One sahih and one hasan. Are you with me? But which one are you going to take? Sahih over there?
Hassan.
Why? Because the Hassan has what? Lesser? His memory is a bit lower.
No.
Khifatul Dabd is mawjood. This one is Tamul Dabd. His memory is on point. Okay? There's a khilaf. Which one is called Shad and which one is called Mahfuz? That's what he's trying to teach you.
Okay.
The one that's left, which is the Hassan, is called Shad, and the one that is taken is called Mahfuz. Okay? فَإِنْ خُولِفَ, if the khilaf comes, بِأَرْجَحَ فَالرَّاجِحُ, the one that's accepted, and that's good, and that's the strongest of the two, is what? Al-Mahfudu. And the weak opposite to one, which is called Marjuh, is the Muqabil, is Shad. So we're going to take what the two are, Shad and Mahfud. First of all, Shad is Ism Maf'ul. Mahfud is Ism Maf'ul, sorry, the Mahfud is Ism Maf'ul, min al-Hifz. And it comes from the word Hifz, safeguard. حَفِظَ الْمَتَاعِ, the Arabs will say. So-and-so has protected the belongings, the properties. يَحْفَظُهُ حِفْظًا, that's what they say. فَوَ حَافِظٌ وَالْمَتَاعُ مَحْفُوظٌ, the one that's looking after the stuffs is called حَافِظ. And the thing that's been looked after is called what? محفوظ. What does it mean? It means مَا رَوَاهُ الثِّقَّةِ. It is what a reliable... Thiqa, when we say, remember, pay attention, brothers. It goes back to the memory and the reliability of the individual. It goes back to those two. It goes to the memory and the reliability of the person. His adl, his justice. How adl and how on point he is. Meaning he's a Muslim, his moral conduct, him reaching age of puberty, and etc. So, it's what a thiqa narrates. Ma rawahu thiqa. He narrates it. مُخَالِفًا, he opposes لِمَنْ هُوَ دُونَهُ فِي الْقَبُولِ, he narrates it to that which a person who's accepted but who's lesser than him. So he narrates a hadith greater and higher than a narration of a person who's lower than him. This is called, the hadith is called محفوظ. What's the evidence, what's the example for this hadith? The example for this hadith is مَا رَوَاهُ التِّرْمِذِي وَأَبُو دَاوُدُ. It is the hadith that's narrated by Al-Imam Tirmidhi and Abu Dawood, min hadithi, on the authority of who? Abdul Wahid ibn Ziyad, who narrated from Al-A'mash, who narrated from Abi Salih, who narrated from Abu Huraira, marfu'an. So the chain is Abdul Wahid. The hadith in Tirmidhi and Abu Dawood. Abdul Wahid ibn Ziyad, ibn Ziyad. عن أعمش from أعمش who أعمش then narrated from who أبي صالح narrated from أبو هريرة مرفوعا that the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said إذا صلى أحدكم if one of you prays ركعتي الفجر the two ركعة of فجر فليضجع على يمينه he should lie on his right a person prays two ركعة of فجر let him lie on his right إذا صلى أحدكم الفجرة فليضجع على يمينه. Here, like Imam al-Bayhaqi رحمه الله, he mentions that عبد الواحد ابن زياد, he's a ثقة. He opposed the others of أعمش students. He opposed others of Amish students. Abdul Wahid ibn Ziyad, he narrated this hadith, even though he's a thika, he opposed who? The other students of A'mash, Sulaiman ibn Mihran. The others who narrated it, who opposed him, are more in him number. They are more in him what? أكثر منه عددا. So, the others narrated it as a prophet action, not his speech. They narrated it that the Prophet ﷺ prayed and he lied down. Not that he ordered it, alayhi salatu wasalam. Now, the hadith of the other students of Sulaiman ibn Mihran, who narrated it as the action of the Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not from his speech, their narration is called what? Mahfuz. And the narration of Abdul Wahid ibn Ziyad is called what? It's called Shadh. It's called Shadh. The second type is called shadh. Shadh means al-munfaridu anil jumhuri. That's what it means linguistically. The word shadh linguistically means what? When a person goes against the majority of the people. It's called shadh. That's what it means linguistically. The Arabs, they say shadha yushadhu bidhammi shin al-mu'jama wa kasriha. Shudhudan idhan farada. Istilahan, the technical definition of the word shadh, there is a lot of views. And I'm going to mention three of them, inshallah. The first one is what the definition of Imam al-Shafi'i, rahimahullah. Shafi'i said, innama shadhu. Shafi'i said, shadh is. Shafi'i said, shadh is. An yarwi thiqa. It is when a thiqa narrates. Hadithan, he narrates a hadith. Yukhalifu ma rawa al-nas. And it goes against that which the people have narrated. So he didn't say it goes against other thiqas. He said it goes against other people. Abu Ya'la al-Khalili, he defined it in his Kitab al-Irshad. He said, "Ash-shadh ma laysa lahu illa isnad wahid." Shadh is the hadith that only has one chain of narration. Yashuzu bidalika al-Shaykh al-Thiqa kana aw ghayrahu thiqa. And it's that which the sheikh who's reliable in it goes against other reliable people, or if it's not reliable people, he goes other against. The third one is Hakim Abu Abdullah. He said that the shad is the hadith الذي ينفرد به الثقة. Shadh is that which a person who is a thiqa, he singles in.